When working on a Blender Python script, you need to make sure that every single time you run your script, you have a clean scene. If you don't, your scene will quickly fill up with objects, meshes, materials from the previous runs of the script. In this video, we'll be taking a look at a building block that will allow you to clean the scene at the start of your script. We'll start off with going over the code. Then I'll show you three examples. And if you stick around, I'll show you how you can get this building block and others without having to copy around code. To take a look at the building block code, let's open the scripting workspace in Blender. Now that we're here, I'm going to create a new text file and paste in the building block code. As you can see, the building block consists of two functions. One is purge orphans and the other is clean scene. We're going to take a look at clean scene first and then the purge orphans after that. The clean scene function consists of a number of things that we need to do to clean the scene. First off, we start off with making sure that nothing is in edit mode. To see what mode the current selected object is in, type in this into the interactive Python console on your left. Hit enter, and it'll show you what mode the object is in. If you change the mode by hitting tab on your keyboard and going into edit mode, check it again, and it'll show you edit mode. Next, we go over and make sure that none of the objects in the scene are hidden for selection or from the viewport. This will make it easier for us to select everything and then delete. You can see if an object is hidden in the outliner. Next, we go and select all the objects in the scene and then hit delete. This is similar to hitting AXD on your keyboard. After that, we find all the collections by collecting their names. If your Blender script generates collections, you want to collect all the collection names and then go and remove them at the start of your script. Next, we find the world object and delete it, and then create a new one and replace it. This is done when you're modifying the world shader. For example, if you're adding HDRIs into your scene, you want to make sure you start off with a new and fresh world object before you start iterating on your script. And finally, we call the purge orphans function. Let's go and take a look at it in detail. The purge orphan function consists of two parts. One will only be executed if the Blender version that you're running is greater than 3.0, and the other is the one, the previous versions. The one at the top is just a single call to the purge orphans function, and the other one is actually a recursive call to this function, so it calls it over and over again. Unfortunately, this is kind of a workaround that you have to do to purge all the orphans recursively. The orphan data blocks are pieces of data that remain in Blender even after you delete an object. So for example, this cube has one material. I'm going to add another material, and right here in the current file, you could see that there's two materials that Blender knows about. Now I'm just going to delete this cube. And as you can see, these materials are still here. So to remove them, you would call the purge orphans function. All right, it's time for some examples. Let's start with example number one. At the very top of this file, nothing has changed, so it's the building block that we just went over. And at the bottom, we have a call to the clean scene function that we just went over, and we're adding an icosphere into the scene. So if I just run it, as you can see, an icosphere appears. If I continue to hit the run script, nothing really changes, right? But it actually does. It deletes the icosphere, we just don't see it, and then adds it again. I'll show you it when I comment out the clean scene function. So I'm going to add a hash character in front of it. So this means that Python won't see it. So it's now invisible. This call is invisible to Python and can't see it. So now I'm going to start just running the script over and over again. And you can see how icospheres will start appearing. So you can see here in the outliner that more and more icospheres are appearing as I run the script. I'm going to remove the comment, so now it's going to run, and as soon as I run it, it's going to clean up everything, and we're going to have only one icosphere. All right, example number two. In this example, we're going to be adding monkey heads with a random location, rotation, and size. At the very top of this file, I've added two imports. It's import to random and import to math. We're going to use this in just a second. At the main code right here, as you can see, we're calling our clean scene building block. Next, we store the value of 360 degrees in radians. So we use the math module we just imported above and get the radiant value for 360 degrees. We store this in the variable right here. We're going to use it in just a second. Next, we have a loop, for loop that loops around in 33 times. So 33 monkey heads will be added into the scene. Next, we're going to get a random size, calling into the random module that we imported above, and getting a value from 0.1 to 2. Make sure to run this in interactive Python console to see how this looks. Next, we're just going to get a random location. So it's X, Y, and Z. Again, similar from -5 to 5. Random rotation right here. Here's where we're actually using the maximum rotation value in radians we just made right here on line 62. Get a value from -360 to +360 for the random rotation. And finally, we add the monkey head into the scene. So, and this will be repeated 33 times. Let's see how this runs. I'm gonna hit the run button. And as you can see, 33 monkeys appeared into the scene. I'm gonna run it again. And again, there are different locations, rotations, and sizes. So I'm gonna run it a couple more times, and that's it. Example number 3. In this example, we're going to be improving on example number 2 by adding a material, a random material with a random color. At the top of this file, nothing has changed. Again, we have our building blocks and our imports. And at the bottom, again, we're calling the clean scene function, getting the max rotation in radians, and looping through and creating 33 monkey heads. Now, right here, this is the main thing that changed between example number 2 and example number 3. On this line, we create a material. We tell Blender that we want to use nodes for this material. We get the BSDF shader and the values for red, green, and blue. Then we use the reference to the BSDF shader and set the RGB value right here to the random values we just generated a couple lines above. Set the alpha to 1, and after that we add this new material to the active object, which is the object that is that was currently created. So the latest monkey head, we appended to the list, so we added to the list of materials for this object. So let's run it and see. I'm going to hit run. Right now you can't see it, it's not in shade mode, so we're gonna activate material preview in the viewport by hitting Z on your keyboard and setting material preview. As you can see, there are a number of materials with random colors set to them. I'm gonna hit a couple more times the run button, and as you can see, we have random location, rotation, also the random color for each material. And for your personal challenge of the day, if you're not following along at home, go back in this video and type in all the Python code that we just went over. Also, take the code example from example number 2 and add a new object to it. You can find how to add new objects by hitting Shift A in the viewport and then adding any mesh you want. Then looking in the bottom of the info panel right here and copying the code, this will be the code that you can use to add another mesh other than the monkey head that we used. Give this video a like if you're learning something new or you want me to do more videos like this. And as promised, you don't have to copy around the code of cleaning the scene into every single Python script you do in Blender. You can replace that code with just one line. The import from the BPY building blocks Python package. To make sure that this code still works, I'm just gonna run it. As you can see, all of this code is commented out, so we're only using the clean scene from the building blocks package. And as you can see, it still works. Fastest way to get this building block Python package is by installing it using the Blender add-on. go to cgpython.com/bpybb, and this will redirect you straight to the release page of this add-on on GitHub. Scroll to the bottom and download the latest zip archive. After that's downloaded, go into Blender. Once you're in Blender, go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, Install, navigate to where you downloaded it, double-click on the archive, and then enable it by hitting the checkbox. Now you'll be able to use the BPYBB Python module in your scripts. For more videos like this, make sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching.